Comparing time periods in Looker Studio is really simple. You have a table here, we've added a comparison column by going down to the chart setup options, and then choosing comparison date range of previous period. Very simple. The problem is we can't really do much with this. We can't sort by the percentage changes to see the biggest movers in this section. The only thing we can really do is go to the style section, and then find the section that says show absolute change here, and then we can change it to say absolute change, but again, we can't sort by this number. We can just look at it and visually see if things have increased or decreased. But what if instead we wanted to have a table where it showed us the actual differences between them in a way that we could sort or even highlight the differences to compare the biggest winners and losers in this time period comparison? In this case, I'm looking at the last 4 weeks versus the previous period. Now on the second page here in Looker Studio, what I've done is created a blend of GA4 with itself. I'll show you what I mean. I'm here in the landing page chart. I'm going to click this pencil icon to open up the blend. What I've created are two tables. The very first table has the landing page dimension and the metric of previous sessions. I renamed the sessions metric so I know which session metric is which. You click on the pencil icon to do this right here, and then you can rename it to whatever you'd like. And then for the time period here, I've selected a custom time period. I'm going to open this up so you can see. The very last option in the time periods is advanced. And in this case, you can do some math. What I'm comparing is last 4 weeks to previous 4 weeks, or previous period in this case. This is the previous period. I've said today minus 8 weeks starts Monday, and then today minus 5 weeks starts Monday. And that's my previous period. Then here in my second table, again, exactly the same GA4 between the two. I'm blending GA4 with itself. Again, the dimension of landing page and the metric of current sessions, which is just renamed session metric. And then for the time period, I've chosen today minus 4 weeks and then today minus 1 week. You could always do fixed time periods as well, or different time periods, maybe this year versus last year, whatever works best for you. Remember that this advanced thing is very powerful. There's a lot of different options that are available in this advanced date range comparison. And the order of these two tables doesn't matter. You could put the more recent period in table 1 and the other time period in table 2. Really doesn't matter. The important thing is the condition, which you can see here. I've chosen the condition of full outer, and the join condition is the landing page. That way I make sure I'm going to get the data correctly from each of the time periods. Now when we pull this open, you can see that we have the landing page, previous sessions, and current sessions, and then I can add a metric that will compare that. I'm going to click Add Metric, and then click Add Field, and in this case we're just going to do some simple math. I've created a custom field here called Change, and all this is taking is the current sessions and subtracting the previous sessions. We're going to click Apply, and now we can see here's the change that has shown up. Now I could also make this a heat map. I could go down to style, scroll on down until you see metric number 3 right here, and instead of number, I'm going to choose a heat map. And now I can actually sort by this as well. Here's the change. I'm just going to make that a bit bigger so it's easier to see. There's the change sorted. What you might also want to do is add a filter to only include pages that had a certain threshold of sessions. That way, for example, something that had just 2 sessions isn't looking totally amazing. I would say maybe a threshold of, say, 50 sessions would be a good place to start. Depending upon the scope of your website, you might have a threshold that's higher or lower for your particular site. If you wanted to make this change a percentage instead of just a number, this is what you would do. Again, you go back to Setup, and then you click on Add Metric. Then click on Add Field. This is how you calculate the percentage change, where you're taking the current sessions, minusing the previous sessions, and then dividing it by the previous sessions. In this case, we're going to name this percent change. And then for the data type, instead of multiplying it by 100, just go to data type numeric and choose percent. And then if you want to have a decimal place, don't forget to select that here. I'll just say 1 decimal place, then click Apply. And now we can see that we have our percentage change showing up. Again, if you wanted to turn this into a heat map, we would go into the Style tab, and then we would change this number drop down to heat map. And then similarly to the change that we saw here, you can sort by this and look at the largest gainers or the biggest losers in this time period. The last thing I'm going to show you is how to add a filter so you can choose only a subset of pages that you want to have show up in this comparison. To do this, there's a number of different ways, but what we're going to do is we're going to control the data that comes in via the data source. We're going to click on the pencil icon to edit the data source. In this case, it's the blend. And then we're going to click on Add Filter. And then we'll say that we're only going to include, and in this case, sessions. We're going to say that it's greater than or equal to, and then we'll pick 50. Make sure to name your filter. We've named the sessions greater than or equal to 50. We're going to hit Save. And then on the second table here, we're going to add exactly the same filter. Because it's the same data source, it'll just work in the second table as well. Then click Save, and we'll close this. And now we can see that this is cleaned up. We're only seeing the stuff in here that actually had more than a certain number of sessions in this time period. And that's how to create sortable time period changes in Looker Studio. Do you still have more questions? Check out our other videos to get more answers and leave a comment letting us know what topics you want us to cover in future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.